We're here at the Champepedon unit of the Northern Tallgrass Prairie National Wildlife Refuge, a unit that the Nature Conservancy helped protect and transfer over to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. About 2019 is when this was restored to help it reconnect with the stream system that floats just a little bit beyond our view here. And when the water goes up in that stream, it connects to this restored feature on the landscape to provide habitat that's critical for the recovery of an endangered species. And what we've seen here after these years is we've got life all around us. We have a recovering oxbow that's filled with water, and terrifically enough, lots of fish species and reproduction happening for this federally endangered Topeka shiner.
In these systems, one of the big questions is, well, what is living in the water? And the only way we can really tell what lives in these oxbows is by physically seeing what's in these oxbows. And the best way that we have to do that is we use the method called seining, and we use a bag seine. We move that through the water and it herds these fish, kind of like you'd herd cattle or something else, herds them into that pocket. And when we pull the net out at the other end, we pull that little pocket out and we look at what's in there. And so then what we do is we count each one and we look for Topeka shiners. And when we find Topeka shiners, we measure a portion of them and determine whether or not they're male or female. And that helps us to determine, number one, whether or not Topeka shiners are using these oxbows, which is one of our primary objectives here, but maybe even more importantly, what community of fish are using the oxbow. Topeka shiners are important, but we need other fish to exist in these as well. So that helps us develop a community analysis of these oxbows, and we can track that over time to determine whether or not these oxbows are improving over time or they need some help to better the results.
Topeka shiner are one of many imperiled species, this one federally listed as endangered. And when prairie streams have been degraded, their populations have gone down and down to the point where we eventually listed them under the Endangered Species Act. Actions like this, oxbow restorations, working on water quality, other things to improve the environment have shown to be effective. The fact that we're seeing these improvements in the populations, the fact that we're seeing the effectiveness of this, not only tells us that it's good for the species, but that it's good for our environment, which means it's good for us too. So we're seeing the benefits from this on-the-ground restoration and the working together of the Nature Conservancy to purchase this property, and then working with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service to help protect it into perpetuity and implement these type of actions, not only here, but across this landscape and across the refuge.